Hello everybody, welcome to the most fun game number 18, I believe, against 2000 TV Chaos. The Nightmare. The Nightmare is real. But now, of course, I just get the beast. Perfect. Right, what does he have? Guard, 3 guard. He's got a block tackle, Mino. Plus strength warrior, blodge agility 4 warrior, couple of claw mighty blows. It's pretty bloaty, I guess. It's not that good, but it's still 2000 TV Chaos, isn't he? He's got security gate. Oh, his record's awful. Hopefully he concedes a lot. No, somebody conceded against him there. He conceded. Destination Uranus. That's Calcium's team, isn't it? So hopefully I just win the coin toss. And yeah, got people to foul him with. I could maybe just go with double bribe actually, rather than the beast. But I think I want the strength against him definitely. Yeah, that was about as bad a 2000 TV Chaos team as you're likely to ever see, to be honest. So, alright. Why the block claw? Because it's normals, yeah. A claw rotter. Yeah, he's got a terrible record. And he's got an unexciting team, really. Maybe I could have spent money for a bay, but maybe he'll... maybe he just concedes every time. Something. He hasn't got a claw pommer, he's got a couple of claw mighty blow. So I really just hope I win the coin toss. And then he might just concede if he takes the cards. Shit, didn't win the coin toss. Fuck. I wish you could play 100 TV for a palmed coin like in the old days. Just win the coin toss for 100k of inducements. Be pretty amazing. Claw Rotter on the line. Oh no, Beast on the line, obviously. Claw Rotter is probably better than a Pestigore, isn't it? Probably better than a Block Pestigore. How fucking stupid is that? Rough losing the toss. Can foul like fuck though, can't I? And maybe he'll concede if I just keep fouling. Yeah, Rotters are pretty good, yeah. Rotters are really quite good. A lot in fear and pitch, yeah. Pestigores are definitely not OP. Pestigores. Oh, I right clicked. I fucking right clicked. Oh, fuck's sake. That's what I get for fucking playing clicker games. No, man. It is an induced beast, yeah. That's why I like not running the beast. Because you know, Chaos don't get a star worth about 200k, you know? They get 300 for Borak, don't they? And then that's really all you've got is Borak for 300. So I think it's quite nice that you can get a beast for 170 if you're down TV. And it can do something. Oh man. Look, he was out of. He wasn't even out of Disturbing Presence. They were both in Disturbing Presence. What a fucking madman. What a fucking madman. They were both in Disturbing Presence. I guess this is how he's got the record he's got, though, right? By doing stuff like this. No, it's not Juegos de Lan. It's not. It's if anything. Beastmen are OP for 60k. They're linemen. And they have. They're like a Pestigo, but 20k cheaper. Pestigos are shit for 80k. Like, they're good once they're a Claw Pommer. And they've got regen for 20k. It's alright. But, if you could take regen as a skill, who would you take it for? War Dancers. Because they already start with Blodge Leap. So I guess War Dancers might even take it first skill. But mostly. You wouldn't give regen first skill to a beastman, would you? You'd give him block, and then you'd give him mighty blow, and then you'd give him claw, and then you'd give him tackle and everything. And even then, you might not give him it. After you'd take block, mighty blow, claw piling on first, wouldn't you? And then probably his tackle, and then so at legend, if you got a beastman to legend, you'd give him regen if it was possible to give it to him on normals. So yeah, I don't think they're OP at all. Time is of the essence. That passing, both the thrower and the catcher were in Disturbing Presence. That's crazy, isn't it? The only bad thing about the beast is that I can't give him. I can't give him guard, can I? Right, so I guess. Oh, I have to blitz this guy. Get to block him as well. With claw. Didn't do anything. Could have done though. He's going to get a 2D him, isn't he? Maybe I shouldn't have followed. Maybe he's GFI there. Oh, but then he gets hit by him. Maybe foul him. Get these guys in here. Make it about the ball. Give him a Nurgle Warrior over there. And get him in a little bit. See what I mean? You don't know what this madman's gonna do. Just don't know what this madman's gonna do. Yeah, it's a claw runner. Saurus, Ducky, Saurus. Saurus. Saurus, Ducky. Andoriolensis, god damn you. Saurus. Saurus. Yeah, Saurus are pretty OP. Oh man, he's got block, fuckhead. Huge. Yeah, Saurus, Tomb Guardians are OP to start with. I wouldn't say Wolves cost a hell of a lot. Wolves are really, really good. But it's hard to say they're OP, isn't it? I think... Yeah, Wardancers and Gutters are the absolute... They're the definition of overpowered, aren't they? And then you've got, like, Saurus are definitely getting there. They're so cheap. And the fact they're 0-6... It also depends how many... like whether you count the number as how powerful it is, if you see what I'm saying. 0-6. The fact you get 0-6 Saurus is huge, isn't it? But when we played the Ultra CRP, it was all about fucking Tomb Guardians, wasn't it? Tomb Guardians, and they basically rendered Saurus obsolete, because when you can have a strength 5 for 100k, why would you have a strength 4 for 80k? Basically, one dicer. Oh, if he double scored there, he might have just conceded in disgust, mightn't he? If I can block these guys, he can get through, can't he, to 2D potentially. Block, 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 block. Everyone could just, it's just easy blocks here. Probably all pushers can get through, I'm not sure. Oh man, fails the dodge for me to make it incredibly easy. Now there's even the recovery on, isn't there? This guy has to block him because, you know, it's claw. So that's not even a choice. And I'll follow just to strand him because he's strength 3. He's a strength 3 shitter. Maybe get the guard in there for the blitz. So make this one first. So I could do a block without block. Then he would go 1, 2, 3. Then he would go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then I get the recovery as well. Bit risky though, isn't it? He would have to go there, and he would go 1-2. Yeah, I think it's worth it for the payoff. Fantastic. Right. Sucks having to. Oh no, I don't have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I don't have GFI once I move him. Now I've got the recovery potentially on. I've got a wizard. He could block him one dice. Make this block first. Yeah. He could 1D him. But then he's gonna, he's not getting, well, no, he's gonna 2D him, and then he's gonna 2D him. I guess getting one, making a one dice is better than taking a two dice, isn't it? Shit, I should have wizarded maybe. induced it. Yeah, I guess I was 55 with a re-roll. About 80%. Is that about 80%? I feel like it is about 80%. I'm gonna have a look what the chance was. I know the first one's 55, isn't it? It's 55 just to knock him down. Yeah, 80. Yeah. Yeah, when you have a free 4D on the ball, yeah, it's true. It was essentially a free 4 dice on the ball, wasn't it? And there's, with the guard being there, it is not really an easy escape for him. His best play was probably dodge here. One dice him, try to score, wasn't it? He hasn't even done it. He just wants to get surfed, apparently. Ugh. Dirty dingo. Still getting surfed, isn't he? Well, surfed or losing it. Whatever happens. So I want to free up the block guy. Oh no, free up the dirty player. He can block. Oh, well, he can block here first. Make the. Oh, okay. First thing, get him down if it's possible. Always want to keep his claw under control. I guess stand up the beast. Because he can. Stand him up, because why not? I guess I should have done safe moves first. So I get to make a claw block here, don't I? Oh, shit. That covers the ball a bit. You can one dice blitz out. You can't even one dice blitz out. Minus two dice blitz out, pick up my tackle zone, score. I guess he could do it, but it's unlikely, isn't it? Claw is line for guaranteed pushes. It feels like that sometimes, doesn't it? But I mean, that's the thing. It's just because your expectation's greater, isn't it? You know? If you were just making a block with a rotter, you'd be like, all right, you've got to push, fine. But because he's got claw or like claw palm, you're like, whoa, it's going to be a Kaz, it's going to be a Kaz. So then when you get the push, you're like, oh, shit. It was only a push. Hello, big time. Claw, yeah. Oh, man. Looking claw. Oh, shit. It's regen, though, hasn't it? Because there was no animation. He had to get the first Kaz out. Oh, no, I got the first Kaz. Oh, that was a surf, though, wasn't it? I've managed to keep his claw mighty blows completely under wraps. And I just knew he'd get a random Kaz.
Why you claw?
My guard out is going to be annoying still, isn't it? One dice powers. Still get to block his claw back though. Keep him down. So I've got a blitz here, haven't I, to get the ball recovery. So I guess block his claw, mate. Block his claw, mate. Blow. Again. Block this claw, mate. Blow. At the end. Might get a power, you never know. Even a both down's decent, isn't it, with Russell? That was annoying. Right, that's good. Good that he used up his blitz near the ball. Not so good that he KO'd best Fagol. Maybe I should have kept in combat contact with him. Yeah, Super Duper Noob played a game. Well, tried to play a game this morning, and it lasted like about 3 turns until the opponent conceded. So that was good. Down so many players, the score's going to be tough, isn't it? Like, it's only two off, and one off for him. But this stun... He's a bit of a bastard. Strength 4 guy with the ball is good though, isn't it? He can make a bit of a screen next turn. But like, I feel like I've got no players. Like, holy shit. Where even are my players? One there, one there. He's got 4. And I've got... He's got 5 and I've got 2. And I've got 3 and he's got 2 and I've got 1. Okay. This guy being stunned, really, really annoying. Thank you for the follow, Nox on Twitch. Yeah, he's basing him, that's fair enough. One dice power, absolutely fucking standard. Feel like the attrition fireball is worthwhile. No, I have to blitz him, don't I? Just do a Randall block first. He gets clawed, that's the bad thing. Maybe I just dodge 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, GFI. No, it seems terrible. I'd love to blitz him though, stand him up, foul him. That would be pretty good, wouldn't it? The other option is he blitzes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ball comes to here, he dodges away. It's fucking rough as fuck. Claw there. Claw there. I guess only one of the claws gets to blitz. Just potato it. Good job he moved his claw mighty blow around. I mean, you can two die these guys down and just fucking make a easy hit on it, can't he? You can base the ball as well. Do you know what? I'm gonna make a pointless GFI. Brilliant. 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 So happy that I saw that I was gonna get based by the Minotaur. And then injured myself on the GFI. Wow. Holy shit. If I was worse at Blood Bowl, I wouldn't have thought about that happening. And wouldn't have made the GFI. Fuck's sake. Oh my god, the beast worth his money? Get banged on. Only badly hurt, surely pixel hug it. Oh yeah, pretty good. Pretty good beast action. Hot beast action. And he still might fail to score, he's only got two turns left, no rerolls. So if he fails the pickup, he doesn't score. This is a pretty hard banger though, isn't it? Clutch regens, however. Two guys removed, both regen and a KO. He's got two reserves, so he'll be on 11 at the moment. I mean, if I come out at 0-0, I'm happy, aren't I? Even though it's been a bit crazy. Get banged on! Alright. This little rotter can score, can't he? This little fucking rotter can actually score, and his players can't. Okay, he can at the moment. So he blocks the claw. Fuck. Ah. There goes that. There goes that fucking plan. I was going to block him, get the beast in to assist there, block him so that he was out of range and tentacled. Then he blitzes him, then he runs and GFIs for the chance. Wow, clutch regens or what? I think I've outplayed him though. I think I've made a lot more. I think I've locked down his claw for the most part. Made a lot more claw mighty blow blocks than him, even though he's got two claw mighty blow and I've only got one. But yeah, holy shit. Thank God for regen, eh? Thank God for regen. That thing in the bottom left is the tip jar. All the partner streamers have one. Where if you can cheer with bits and stuff, and then I get some sense from that. Right, he could not do anything. He can one dice him. He could blitz him, and then he could come in to assist, potentially. If this is on a POW. No. One dice block then with claw. Let's do this. Okay, we'll stop the score. Still got the wizard. This is going to be crucial whether the tackler comes back, isn't it? Pretty nice, Kaz, to be fair. Got a full team. Maybe I should have fouled more with having the with having so many reserves. But at least, I mean, even if I'd failed all of the regens, I would have still had an 11-man team, wouldn't I? Although it would have been a decimated team, it would have still been 11 players. Yes, yes, Ducky. Every cent counts when you've got 25-cent beers. They weren't perms, though. See, that's why the regens worked, because they weren't perms. Had they been perms, however, they would have been failing in force. I'm not even going to play the beast this half. Fuck the beast. I'd literally rather have a rotter on the pitch. He can tackle him. He can go for the blitz. I guess he's better off getting the claw block, isn't he? Then some randomer. 1, 2, 3, 4 back. Seems good. Oh yeah, I need the sense for my fake son. Yep, that's true. Right, there you go. This is why I don't like the beast, because I'm not even going to play him. I'd literally rather have a wrestle rotter than the beast, or a dirty player rotter than the beast. So this is why the beast isn't on the team. Defense, it's fair enough, because you know it was a player that was quite strong that I didn't give a fuck about. But I just don't even want him. Crushes chaos children. Whoop whoop. Was Fasher's maths correct? Riot doing something. Come on, Claw. Claw does nothing, but random block gets him. I gotta go for this, haven't I? Just hope it's not a both down. Alright, good. Oops, don't fucking GFI, you prick. Coming here for a 3-dicer. Why is that not a 3-day? Oh, because it's not a block. Derp. Base him with a shithead. Because I'd really like to foul with dirty player later. Now it's a 3-dicer, isn't it? Fucking hell. What a cunt. Right. And I guess just go for the pickup now. These are all right where they are, aren't they? Eight point 0 6 to 8.58. I'm done. Interesting, eh? Good old goblin spy doing work. It's a pretty cool website, TBH. That's nice, isn't it? Oh no. Alright, he didn't do it. But that would have been nice, blitzing him from there to get the push into these guys to get extra blocks, but just did not do it. Quim just played his chaos on the most recent matches. Oh man. Oh man, that was so funny. A coach called Quim. Made me lol. Yeah, but a loss is devastating for both of us. Wow, we're just minus 2D. What a fucking madman. A loss is absolutely devastating for me or Lupak. It's going to take a lot of wins to... If one of us loses, it's going to take a lot of wins to get back. But yeah, if he wins, he goes to 8.77. But then I'd win. Would go to 81.07. So yeah. Yeah, pretty interesting. Pretty interesting race, isn't it? It's good. It's good, the race. Like, but yeah, if either of us lose, we get banged on, effectively. Ah, oh, you cunt! Fuck's sake. And he's got fucking dodge. Alright, that was a good block though. That makes up for always failing to knock down his claw mighty blows. And now this is a nice dirty player foul as well, isn't it? Guards ready to do stuff. Plus three assist foul with dirty player. Surely get a KO. Surely have to get a KO here. Must get a KO. Sent off for no armor break. Standard. Maybe I should have tried to get a guard in there instead of him. But... Wow, he greeds it. Maybe I should have greeted it. Maybe I should have greeted the hit on him before. But I mean, he's just hitting a fucking block pestigo. I don't think the block pestigo is worth a greed hit. TBH, fam. Sneaky gate, yeah, sneaky gate would have been just the ticket then, wouldn't it? Oh, man. That would have been so good if I just KO'd him for the send-off. It'd have been great, wouldn't it? That would have been a three-assist dirty player foul. I think that... Has anyone got Squirrel Dude's link on hand to see if that was a good foul or not? It felt like a good foul. Three assists against armor... Against armor 8 with dirty player. Seemed like a good foul. Felt like a good foul. See what we can do here. Get him in there. So he blocks him to free the claw guy. He can just straight up block him because he's strength 4. Blitz him, then block him, block him. Could block him, then blitz him. Block him. Yeah, that's better, isn't it? Oh wow, injury, huge. It's big, it's huge. So I greed this, I gotta get the pow here. Excellent. Andy stranded on the guard and strength 4. Not so stranded anymore. Casey blocks him out and tries to get something on the ball. 1D him, might as well. Not really anything that can go wrong there. Maybe I should have followed, maybe not. Nobody knows. Yeah, that was, maybe I shouldn't have pushed him to there. Because that did give him that 2-dice blitz, didn't it? Only stunned though, that's okay. Quite like the wrestling, though. I do like wrestling shit players. Wrestling shitheads. That's why I don't like it on the witches, you know, I like it on shitheads. I really do. Alright. So, claw on his claw guy. Surely it's gotta work eventually. No. Should be able to get moving a little bit this turn with a pow. Banged on! Finally got him. Alright, that's pretty nice. So he goes 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the claw guy goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this guy can like go out to here. Excellent. Happy about that. can't fucking see anything, can you? Jimmy from the Bronx. We'll do first Super Duper Noob. They did the first half. Like, to be fair, he made fucking three cars first half. I just regen them all. You know, and if I hadn't regen them all, I wouldn't have been able to make these cars in the second half. So, but yeah, that was pretty good from a fucking scary matchup, isn't it? When I saw a 2000 TV Chaos team, I shat my damn pants. Whereas now it's not so bad, is it? It's looking that way, isn't it, StarDK? I mean, it was only, like, the first half it wasn't his drive, which is why it wasn't that bad. Like, if you want to get banged on, it's better to get banged on your opponent's drive, isn't it, than your own. It's looking pretty good now. Without wanting to jinx it. A strength 4 carrier means you can only get one dice, doesn't it? You have region, he doesn't. But I could have just as easily failed all three, could I? I mean, I was still lucky that I actually made the regens. Couple of rando GFIs there. Make sure you run all the way back. Foul appearance, come on, one dice. He's a bit of a dirty dingo, isn't he? Bit of a dirty dingo on the quiet, this one. Base the ball carrier. Still got the bolt. Haven't forgotten. So if I have to use it, it's there, isn't it? Maybe come into a kind of thing over here. Yeah. Blitz him with him. Couldn't move the other guy first, unfortunately. Good. Claw! Claw on the rotter, come on, do something, Claw. No. Good, isn't it, actually? Wish I was 1-0 ahead, though. It's still anybody's game, isn't it? The odd, like, you know, a quad skull or something. You never know. That stun's pretty good, because it's a strength guy, isn't it? Basing it. Randomly basing for no reason. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. I actually meant to put him there, and then just didn't. Yeah, overall, yeah, Super Duper Noob. Yeah, obviously, odds-wise, yeah, 50-50 is better than 1-up. Oh, yeah, of course. In the attrition game, the odds favour Nurgle, but that doesn't mean that it's going to work out that way every time, does it? Or even, well, I guess it does matter. It does mean that it'll matter that way most. It'll come out that way most of the time, but certainly not every time. Shit, the alert box isn't on. It's still broken, is it? It's still broken. Fuck. Do you know what? I should have restarted the stream when the game ended, when the one of the other games ended. But thank you very much, Roxash. Thank you very, very much for the subscription. Welcome to Team Fantastic. And I will play the alert. I will restart the stream after this game. And I will then play the alert. That's bad, isn't it? See, because I didn't want to base with him. I didn't want to base with him because I knew he'd just fucking block him. Whereas if I had the two there... It's annoying that it's so hard. It's just things are just not working out very well. But should have enough men to maybe do something here. He blocks him. He blocks him and then move over here. Still got the wizard, of course. Mighty blow hit there. Oh, huge. Huge. That was pretty lucky, wasn't it? Huge injury. Claw mighty blow on him. Yeah. Then that sandwiches in between two Nurgle warriors. He then gets to go there to assist this block. Oh man. Mad Kaz. This is crazy Kaz. This is crazy Kaz. But the ball isn't safe, is it? There's no way of getting the ball safe. Despite murdering his entire team. Maybe run over here. Like to there. But then that's just a dodge away and another dodge away. This is like a dodge. This is kind of safe, I guess. I'll just stay where I am. Kind of safe. Crazy! What a crazy turn. Yeah, maybe I could have whizzed this guy. Maybe I could have bolted that guy at the end, yeah. That wasn't even Claw Guy that did that, was it? Claw Guy must be KO'd. Yeah. Movement 7 carrier, so needs one square in next turn. I don't think he's got enough players to make to make that necessary. Random. I guess we can push it out that way, but still. A push is no good for him anyway, is it really? He needed the power. He's pushed him there, so he just used extra movement for no reason. It's pretty crazy, isn't it, Aladdin? It's pretty crazy, you would think. With yeah, he's made his records 1-5, lost 22. He's conceded a few times before. I know, right, Pedro Jack? It's crazy. To be fair, though, it was they made them that turn and stuff, and so it was. It wasn't that crazy. I mostly made them that turn. And he did have a strength 5 fucking warrior and stuff. Yeah, it's a nice little star player point farm. Right. Okay, so Mighty Blow blitzers. Stand him up. Safe moves first. Can't move the ball carrier first. Oh man. Another AV break. Right, so if I bolt him, 1, 2, 3, GFI, GFI, he can't base me here. But then he could surf me. So gotta go here. Gotta go here. We'll bolt him at the end of the turn. The other guy got guard, no. Stomp him. Yeah, it is 7 cars, yeah. Yeah. And 2 kills. Pretty crazy. Pretty crazy in the end, this game. Right, 1, 2, 3. GFI, GFI. So all he can do is base the ball. And he'd have to blitz one of these to do it. So now he could go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, GFI, GFI. He could hit the ball, so it's definitely worth the bolt here. Another Kaz. Banged on! If there's too many, then it just goes into the KO's box as well. Oh man. That was crazy to just get another Kaz. I could make a greedy 3D on him. Might as well. If I don't win a game because of a fucking failed 3 dice with block, then it's just unlucky, isn't it? I think it's worth the greed. A claw, mighty blow hit, you know. He wants the star player points, doesn't he? I don't even know if there's any long-term effects. I think it's mostly badly hurts, to be honest.
Greed is good. Greed is right. Greed works.
Yeah, it's like 1 in 46,000 to draw instead of win. It was worth the risk. 8 Kaz. And I've only got 1 claw mighty blow. Isn't that crazy? And it's funny because the first half was the half that I got outbashed. Where I thought I actually, you know, I thought I out-positioned him in the first half. I thought I got great, you know, great blocks on him, what have you. You know, limited his claw mighty blow hits. Made as many as I could of my own. I thought I'd played really quite well the first half in terms of the bash matchup, and just didn't win it. And then second half, just randomly Kaz the fuck out of him without even doing anything good. Funny old game, innit? Yeah, a decent amount of star player points, yeah. Yeah, he got banged on a bit, didn't he? He did get a little bit banged on. It's true. least the touchback doesn't matter. Four players left. Like, it's crazy he had 13 players, so he actually had some fucking players to put on the pitch. I don't know. Okay, we'd have had two, but you know what I mean. Oh. Well, you've only got to win by one, haven't you? Oh man. J5, that's pretty bad. That's pretty bad. Dirty Dingo J5. Holy shit. Yeah, if you have three or less, they all have to go on the LOS. Yep, that's correct, Rockstar. Yeah, depression for his players, yeah. And shame. So it commits the dog. Oh, 1-0. To be fair, 1-0 doesn't matter. I think it's cute that the Rotters only get one claw because they're only strength 3 shitters. 6 for winnings, good. Oh wow, the best Fagor gets the MVP, so he's so close. 16 AV breaks into 6 injuries, and he sustained 8 altogether. And that's what, 11 for best Fagor. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 20. So yeah, best Fagor made 3 Kaz and then got the MVP. Pretty good. Pretty good that just the random mighty blow tackle guy didn't even need claw, did he? Obviously, he'll get claw next. That'll be amazing. You can't imprint Augustus. You can't recruit mercenaries. That should be the rule Miraz could do, but I believe it's not implemented correctly in Blood Bowl 2, but I'm not sure. So, yeah, he's a touchdown away now. He's a Kaz. He's a touchdown. I mean, the touchdowns are rare for Nurgle Warriors. That's the great thing about Chaos, isn't it? If this was a Chaos team, it'd be pretty easy to farm the touchdowns on them to skill them up. But there you go. Yeah, that's pretty good, isn't it? Pretty good that he's pretty close to getting Claw. And he'll be a lot better. I mean, the team will be so much better when he gets Claw. Just by itself. Then I guess I've got to get as many touchdowns as I can on this guy. And, yeah. Don't know what to do with this 40k extra. Could buy the enhancement now and just go down to 90k. It wouldn't be so bad, I guess. But, right. You don't lose if you can't field 3. It's if you can't field any J5 is when you give up the touchdowns, when you just can't put anybody on the LOS. Right, thank you for watching, everybody. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. And stay fantastic.